Next one. In 1939, there was a scientist in Russia, there was a photographer in Russia. Semyon Kirlian, his name was Semyon Kirlian, and he was that time doing research on inventing sensitive photographic paper. He wanted to invent such a paper which could take photograph of very, very small particles. Accidentally, and so many times scientific inventions have come accidentally. The way the apple fell and some principle has come. Similarly, this Aura photographer was, camera was invented accidentally. He was doing his research on inventing the scientific, sensitive photographic paper. Accidentally, his small finger came in the lens shutter of the camera. And when he developed the photograph, this finger came in very bad shape, as if it was not well, as if it was a diseased finger. He was surprised and shocked that my finger is so nice, healthy, how this photograph has come. He could not understand. And therefore, he just put that photograph aside, started his work. Now, after 6 months, when he got up in the morning, he found that his finger had become the same that was seen in the photograph. Some disease had come on the finger. He got the tube light, and he thought that something can be done to see something is going to come in future, can be seen today. And then he started doing work on this, and that photographic paper, sensitive paper came on side, and he started work on this. And he conveyed this happening to other scientists, and those scientists also started working to develop a camera which can take photograph of the organs of our body which are going to have disease in future. And this is the history of Aura camera. And after about 20 years of research, 1980 to 2000, one another scientist called Samuel Kirlian. After Samuel Kirlian came Dr. Konstantin Korotkov. Dr. Konstantin Korotkov is another scientist who did research in between 1980 and 2000, and he invented another camera called Bio-Well, and this camera can take photograph. This camera can be seen in our stall 38. This camera can take photograph of our energy body and tell us what disease we are going to have in future. Now, this is the picture of the aura. In Kirlian camera, we are not to take the photograph of the body, not to take the photograph of the face, but the photograph is taken of the fingertips. The question comes, why the fingertips? If you see and observe our palm reflects the full body. When astrologer sees our palm, he sees the lines on the palm. And a good astrologer can tell us everything about our life by studying the lines of the palm. There are mounts on the palm. Similarly, on the tips of our finger, before that I will tell you about the fingerprints. No two persons' fingertips in the world can match. And this is the principle of the police department to keep the track of the terrorist. Fingertips never match. Why? We do not know. Similarly, from the fingertips, something comes out of our body. And this is the energy coming out, radiating continuously through the fingertips of both the hands, right hand and left hand. This camera takes the advantage of energy coming out from the fingertips. Each finger is related to different organs of our body. We have got right side half and left side half. Right side half is represented by right hand, left side by left hand. If we take the fingertips, photographs of the 10 fingers, we can take the full picture of our full body, and that comes in the form of this shape. If a person is healthy, you will find that the aura of the person will be of the same thickness without any break, and depending upon the health of the person, the thickness of the aura will be there. If there is good energy, it will be thick. If it is he is not having good energy, the thickness will be small. So this is the aura of the person, and it is the subtle energy, not our physical body energy. When a person is sick, for example, you will get a lot of cuts here. These cuts show that he has got problem in various organs, and that organs, that problems will be shown in the report, which will come subsequent slide. Now we can see the chakras. There is no system at the moment. Even if you spend, there are machines of 2 crores and 10 crores and 25 crores, scientific machines. They are trying to find out where is chakra, where is nadi. They cut off the person, of course, during post-mortem of dead body, living body they don't do so far. But they try to find out where are chakras, where are the nadis. They are not able to trace them because they are not physical, they are not material. They are in the form of energy. And energy cannot be seen, cannot be measured, or cannot be photographed. So for this simple reason, these chakras cannot be depicted by any photograph, any camera or any machine so far invented by science. So this camera, which is not scientific camera, we can say, not a normal scientific camera, it is a paranormal, subtle energy, taking photograph, which takes the photograph, subtle energy. So we can see the 7 chakras here, and this is the chakras of a person who has done meditation. After meditation, we get the chakras in a straight line, which are larger in size, with more energy. And if a person has got problems, the chakras will be small. These are still bigger, but even smaller than this, and they will be scattered. They will not be in a straight line. Next one. Now, this is explaining you about the Aura camera. Now, question comes. When we take our Aura photograph, what precautions we should take that the readings that come to us are correct and chances of incorrectness is not there. Some precautions we have to take. Number one, our energy body is directly connected with our mood. If you are angry, if you are not in a good mood and take Aura photograph, we'll get something else. So for that purpose, we have to keep quiet, be calm, take some rest, and then we only have to go for Aura photography. Number two, if we have got nails on our fingers, they will not, of course, we don't permit them to take the photograph. The nails should not be there. Number three, if we take food, immediately we cannot go for Aura photograph because our energy is more concentrated on digestion and we do not get the result by photographing. So these are some of the precautions we have to take. But fact remains that this camera is going to bring revolution. The tests which are to be done for a number of days at number of places can be avoided by taking this photograph, and within 15 minutes we get the report of the full body health problems as well as the future problems. Now I want the question from you.
Two questions.
Yes, sir.
One is that you said it's a wavelength.
Yeah.
So it is a frequency basically.
Of course.
So what is the frequency measured? I mean, what is the number? The number, what is the frequency of that wavelength? Aura is a wavelength.
Of course it is, but it depends. It is different in different places, different people. It comes in the photograph. You can see that what is the frequency.
So measured in frequency, always the wavelength is measured in frequency. Right? So what is the frequency basically composed of? The spectrum is composed of a frequency, right?
We are not interested to go in details of frequency measurement. We are doing this work, and of course the camera also, the inventor himself was more interested in showing the diseases rather than details of the frequency. So we don't have that, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you very much.
To buy Bio-Well camera now, please log into our website www.jmshah.com or call us at 98210-55216.